there with you. Okay, so today's our first problem is water flows at the rate of 10 meters per minute through a cylindrical pipe 5 millimeter in diameter. How long would it take to fill a conical vessel whose diameter at the surface is 40 centimeter and depth is 24 centimeter? Okay, this is the first word problem. Okay, once again I am going to read this. See carefully. Water flows at the rate of 10 meters per minute. Okay, rate is given 10 meters per minute, for 1 minute 10 meters through a cylindrical pipe. So here we need to think about cylinder. Okay, cylindrical pipe, 5 mm in diameter. Diameter is given 5 mm. Understood? So here one thing you can understand, that is here it is given in 10 meters and this is given in millimeter. Okay, so units are different. Okay, so next, what is given? See, how long would it take to fill a conical vessel, whose diameter at the surface is 40 centimeter and depth is 24 centimeter. Okay, diameter is given 40 centimeter and depth is given 24 centimeter. This is about conical vessel, means cone. Okay, so what is the problem? See, there is a cylindrical pipe. Okay, there is a cylindrical pipe. You can see figure, conical pipe. Okay, what is given? 5 mm in diameter. Its diameter is given 5 mm. Means this is 5 mm. Diameter is 5 mm. Okay, and what is given? A rate of 10 meters per minute. For 1 minute, 10 meters. Okay, so if this is, we will think about 1 minute, then this distance is 10 meters. This distance is 10 meters. Okay, that is the length of the cylinder, length of the cylindrical pipe. Means what we have to consider? This is the height of the cylindrical pipe. Okay, length is equals to the height of cylinder. Understood? Now what is given after this? C, diameter is given, so we can find out radius from this. Length is given. Okay, only the thing is that we need to make unit same. Okay, once you will make, we will make unit same, then easily we can find out volume. Okay, now what is the thing? See, how long would it take? Means here we have to find out time. How long would it take to fill a conical vessel? See, from this water, whatever water is going to come, there is one conical vessel. Okay, and its dimensions are also given. What is given? 40 centimeter. What is 40 centimeter? Diameter. Diameter of this conical vessel is 40 centimeter. And depth is given 24 centimeter. Depth means what? Height. Height is given 24 centimeter. Two things are given. Understood? So how much time it will take? How long would it take? We have to find out time. Understood? So first, here we need to find out volume of cylinder whose length is 10 meter and diameter is 5 mm. Okay, we have to find out volume of this cylinder, and then we have to find out volume of cone. Understood? Definitely volume of cone is greater than the volume of cylinder. Okay, so finally what we will do here, we have to divide the volume of cone, that is conical vessel, by the volume of cylindrical pipe. Okay, so that is the flow of our answer. Why we are dividing, getting everybody? Here they have told us this is of 1 minute. Understood? So this pipe we have considered whose length is 10 meter and diameter is 5 mm. So we are going to find out volume of this. Okay, because whatever water is going to flow from this, that is going to be in the conical vessel. Okay, so then only we can find out required time. Okay, so first we will find out volume of cylindrical pipe. Okay, to find out volume of cylindrical pipe, we use formula pi r square h. Okay, here we need to make unit same. This 10 meter and 5 mm we have to bring under same unit. Okay, so where here we will bring in the centimeter. Okay, all the units we will bring in the centimeter. These units are given in centimeter, only we will change this. Okay, so length, that is the height, is equal to 10 meter. So that is the 10 meter, 10 multiply by 100. 10 multiply by 100 is 1000 centimeter. Okay, so height is 1000 centimeter. Now diameter is given. Diameter is 5 mm. Diameter is 5 mm. So radius will be, radius is equal to 2.5 mm. Radius will be 2.5 mm. Half of the diameter is radius. Okay. Again, this is in millimeter. So we have to convert into centimeter. Okay. So millimeter, when you will convert to centimeter, that time we need to divide by 10. Okay. So radius is equal to 2.5 divided by 10. That is 0.25 centimeter. So this is our required radius. Okay. Now, height is also in centimeter, radius also is in centimeter. So we can find out volume of cylindrical pipe. Okay, so now I'm taking that volume of cylindrical pipe is equal to pi r square h, volume of cylinder. Okay, so pi I'm going to keep as it is because finally we are going to do division. So here also we will get pi, so directly we can cancel that. So pi I'm keeping as it is. Okay, so pi multiply by radius. What is the radius of this? 0.25 centimeter. So I'm taking that 0.25 multiply by 0.25 because square multiply by height. Height means what? A length. Okay. So that is 1000 centimeter. So centimeter cube. 10 meter. We have converted this into 1000. Okay. So now we will find out product of this. That is pi multiply by 0.25 into 0.25 will be 0.0625 square. Okay, after 4 digit decimal point, multiply by 1000 centimeter cube. Okay, so when you will multiply this, that time what we will get, this decimal point will shift 3 digits forward because there are 3 zeros. So you will get 62.5 pi centimeter cube. So this is the volume of cylindrical pipe. This is the volume of cylindrical pipe. Okay, so now we will find out volume of conical vessel. Okay, second thing we have to find out volume of conical vessel. So for that, radius, what is the radius? 40. Okay, so radius that I am taking capital R. Okay, radius is equal to 40 by 2, that is 20 centimeter. Okay, capital R is, we have taken radius of the conical vessel. Okay, so that is 20 centimeter. Height, that also I am taking h. Okay, so height is taken directly, given directly, so that I am taking directly 24 centimeters. Okay, so now we will find out volume of conical vessel. Volume of conical vessel is equals to 1 by 3 pi r square h. 1 by 3 pi r square h. Okay, so now here 1 upon 3 pi I am keeping as it is, multiply by radius. What is the radius of this? Is 20 centimeters. So 20 multiply by 20 into height is 24 centimeter cube. Okay, so 3 ones are 3, 3 eights are 24. Okay, now what is remaining here? 20 into 20, 20 20s are 400, 400 into 8, 3200 pi centimeter cube. Okay, so this is the volume of conical vessel. This is the volume of conical vessel. Okay, so now what we have to do, we have to divide this volume of conical vessel divided by volume of cylinder, then we will get time, required time. Okay, so here I am doing that division, that is 3200 pi divided by 62.5 pi centimeter cube. Here also centimeter cube, and it will be cancelled. Understood? Pi also we can cancel. Understood? Pi will be cancelled. So time required is equals to 3200. If you will shift this decimal point one digit forward, then there will be 32,000. So this, here you will get 32,000 divided by 625. Okay, when we will divide this, that time we will get 51.2. 51.2. 51.2 means what? 51 minutes and 2 seconds. Okay. So this is our the required answer. 51 minutes and 2 seconds. Okay. So this is our required answer. Once again, see what was given. Water flows at the rate of 10 meters per minute through a cylindrical pipe. So we are thinking first about cylindrical pipe. 10 meters in 1 minute. Okay. So we have taken the height, that is length, for 1 minute. Understood. So finally we have to find out timing. So 10 meter we have converted into centimeter, that is 1000 centimeter. Mm also we have converted into centimeter, that is 0.25. understood, 0.25 centimeter. And volume of cylindrical pipe you will find out, that time will get 62.5 pi centimeter cube. Okay, then we have to think about conical vessel. So conical vessel radius and height is given directly, so pi r square h. Okay, here we have taken capital R and here we have taken capital H. So pi r square h is equal to 1 by 3 pi 20 into 20 multiplied by 24, 3200 pi centimeter cube. Okay, so volume of conical vessel divided by volume of volume of cylindrical pipe. So that we have done here division and we got answer 51.2, that is 51 minutes and 2 seconds. Okay. Okay, our second problem is an iron pillar consists of a cylindrical portion 2.8 meter high and 20 centimeter in diameter and a cone 42 centimeter high is surmounting it. Find the weight of the pillar. Given that 1 centimeter cube of iron weighs 7.5 grams. Okay, so here see once again problem I am reading here. An iron pillar consists of a cylindrical portion 2.8 meter high. Cylindrical portion is there. Okay, iron pillar 2.8 meter cylindrical portion. So this is 2.8 meters cylindrical portion. Understood. Now, 2.8 meter high and 20 centimeter in diameter. So this diameter is 20 centimeter. This is given 20 centimeter. Okay, one more thing here, 2.8 meter and this is centimeter. Units are different. Now, and a cone 42 centimeter high is surmounting it. Okay, surmounting it means here there is a cone whose height is 42 centimeters. Okay, find the weight of the pillar given that 1 centimeter cube of iron weighs 7.5 grams. Okay, so here we have to find out weight of the pillar. Means here we have to find out volume. Understood, volume of whole pillar. Okay, but in that pillar there is a cylinder and a cone. Understood. So separately we can find out volume of cylinder and volume of cone, and finally we have to do the addition of both the volumes. Understood. And once we will do addition of both the volumes, we have to multiply by 7.5 grams. Understood. And finally, if possible, then we can convert into kilograms. Understood. So what we are going to do here, first we will find out volume of cylinder base. Anyhow, we can find out volume of cone first. Anyhow, so first I am going to find out volume of cylinder. Okay, to find out volume of cylinder, what is the formula? Pi r square h. Okay, radius, diameter is given 20 centimeter and height is given 2.8 meter. So we have to make unit same first. Okay, so radius of cylindrical portion, that is cylinder, is equal to 20 by 2, that is 10 centimeter. Okay, radius we got here 10 centimeter. Now we will think about height. Okay, height is given 2.8 meters. So meter we need to convert into centimeters. Understood. So we will multiply by 2.8 multiply by meter into centimeter, we will multiply by 100. Okay, so it will be 2.8 multiplied by 100 means 2800, that is after one digit, that is 2.80 centimeters. 2.80 centimeter is the height of the cylinder. Understood? Now we have radius, we have height, so we can find out easily volume of the cylinder, that is the weight. So volume of cylinder, cylindrical portion, is equals to what we will do, pi r square h. Understood? So that is 22 by 7 multiplied by radius is 10 into 10 multiplied by height. Height is, what is the height of that? 280 centimeter, that is centimeter cube. Okay, so now here we can find out 7 4s are 28, so that is 40. Okay, so now here what is remaining? 10 10s are 100. 100 into 22 multiplied by 22 multiplied by 40. 22 4s are 88 and 0 into 10 10s are 100 centimeter cube. Okay, so now here this will come, two zeros will increase, that is 88,000 centimeter cube is the volume of this, volume of cylindrical portion. Okay, so now after this we will find out volume of conical portion. Okay, so volume of conical portion we need to find out, that is its radius. What will be the radius? Radius of cone, conical portion, that is 20 by 2, that is 10 centimeter. Radius of cylindrical portion and conical portion is same, 10 centimeter. So directly also we can use. Second thing, height is given 42 centimeter. Okay, so what is the volume? How will find out volume of cone? Volume of conical portion is equals to 1 by 3 pi r square h. Okay, so 1 by 3 multiply by 22 by 7 multiply by radius. Radius is 10, so 10 multiply by 10 and height is 42 centimeter cube. Okay, so now here we can divide 3, 7 ones are 7, 7 6 are 42. Now 3 ones are 3, 3 2s are 6. Okay, so what is remaining here? 10 10s are 100, 100 into 2, 200 multiply by 22. Okay, so that will be 22 multiply by 200 centimeter cube. So that is 4400 centimeter cube. So this is the volume of conical portion. Okay, so now we have to do the sum of this volume plus this volume, and then we will multiply by 7.5 grams. Okay, so now I am doing that. Total volume is equals to, what is total volume? 88,000 plus 4,400. Okay, so total volume is equal to 88,000 plus 4,400 centimeter cube. Okay, so it will be 92,400 centimeter cube. This is the total volume of that pillar. Okay, this is the total volume of that pillar. But this is not our final answer. What they have told us, given that 1 centimeter cube of iron weights is 7.5 grams. So here we need to multiply by 7.5. Okay, at the same time we can convert this into kilogram also. Understood? So what we will do here, 92,400 multiply by 7.5. 92,400 multiply by 7.5. At the same time this is given in grams, so we can divide by 1000. We can divide by 1000 to convert into kilograms. So here it will be kilograms. Okay, so finally your answer will be 693 kilograms. Okay, so see here once again see what was the problem. An iron pillar consists of a cylindrical portion
2.8 meter high and 20 centimeter in diameter. Okay, there is a pillar whose base is cylindrical and top is conical. Understood? Both the things are given. 2.8 meter high means height is given and 20 centimeter diameter. So radius we can find out. Only units are different. So we have done here units same. Okay, this is the part of answer. So here we got 10 centimeter. 280 centimeter is the height of the cylindrical portion. So we can find out volume of cylinder pi r square h. So we have taken the values. So 88,000 centimeter cube is the volume of that cylindrical portion. Okay, then surmounting, it is surmounted by cone, conical portion. So we have taken the radius of cone 10 centimeter, radius of cylindrical portion and conical portion will be same. So not necessary to find out, directly we can write. So height is 42 centimeter, that is given, and units are same. So volume of conical portion is equal to 1 by 3 pi r square h. So 1 by 3, 22 by 7, 10 into 10, this when you will calculate this, that time you will get 4400 centimeter cube. Now we have to do the sum of both the volumes. So we have taken here total volume 88,000 plus 4400. Okay, so sum of that is 92,400 centimeter cube. But here they have told us 7.5 grams. 1 centimeter cube of iron weighs 7.5 grams. So here we have multiplied by 7.5. Okay, but this we have to convert into kilograms. So directly in grams also we can write. But this is a big amount, okay, big number. So we need to convert into kilograms. Okay, so that will be convenient to give answer. So when you will divide, when you will solve this, when you will shift this digit, 75 upon 10,000 will come, 25 it will be divisible. So we can divide, zero zeros we can cancel, multiply by 75, you will get 693 kilograms. So that is our required answer. Okay.